Hey, what's up guys, Pablo Munoz here. Welcome to the third part of this mini tutorial series on how to create iridescent materials in 3D. So in this video, we're gonna recreate that effect inside ZBrush using MatCaps and some of the renders that we created in Blender. So let's go ahead and jump straight into it. All right, so here we are in ZBrush and I'm using the standard UI so that you can follow along. And I'm using ZBrush 2022.0.5, but this technique works with, I think, absolutely any version of ZBrush. It's very, very simple. As long as you have access to MatCaps, you will be able to do this technique. So I have the final model of this crab with a little bit of poly paint in here. But to really understand the effect of the matcap, or at least how to fake this iridescent material in matcaps within ZBrush, I have a very simple test image that I'm going to share with you guys. So this one right here. And it's a very simple image, basically a progression of blue, or like rings from blue to magenta. And the idea is that once we applied this into the matcap, you will be able to see that progression kind of like in the glazing angles, or the Fresnel effect of this color. And that is, in a way, the effect of the iridescent material, that you can see the strength of the effect more towards the glazing angles of a object, or like to the edges. So with that in mind, let's go back into ZBrush and I'm going to use that image. All right, so I'm going to double click in here to open up my left tray, and I'm going to click on the material palette here and drag in here. And I'm going to select something like Chrome A, which is a matcap that I don't use often, because ultimately what we're going to do is replace the image that this matcap is using. It could be absolutely any matcap that you don't use. All right, so let's go ahead and turn off the poly paint as well, so we have like a clear view of what this material is doing. And I'm going to open up the modifiers, and at the bottom of the modifiers, for most matcaps, you'll see an image in here. So I'm going to click on that one, and I'm going to click import. And from the browser window, I'm going to select my test image, and that's it. As you can see, this is the image that I just showed you before, and it's being added to a matcap. So now whenever I move around, we have those that effect. So this is a very, very strong, very sharp, almost like a stylized version of the iridescent material. But I just wanted to do it this way because I think this showcases the effect, or like you will be able to understand a little bit better how this effect works. And if nothing else, this is a pretty cool matcap that you can use for like, you know, like that sort of predator view, or you know, you can just change the colors a little bit and it's that sort of like infrared or a thermal sort of vision, which is pretty cool. So anyway, this is the point, that you can input absolutely any image that you want in here, and this is the effect that you get from that matcap. Obviously, you can tweak a few things here and there, but this is the basics. Nothing, I haven't changed anything in here. You see everything is pretty, you know, the default settings are pretty much the same. The only difference is just this image. So with that in mind, if I jump back to my Blender file, so this is something that I cover in the video where I show you how to create this effect in Blender. So all I've done here is I rendered this sphere that has the material that we created in Blender, and I exported that in here. So this is my final render of that sphere with a black background. And I save this as a PNG file as well. And all I'm going to do now is I'm going to click on this test image and I'm going to replace it with that sphere. And there we go. Now we have this iridescent material or matcap inside ZBrush working really, really nicely. Of course, there's a couple of things that you can do to improve that and tweak it. So I have done already a few versions of this material with the same image. So I'm going to click on that one. So there we go. This is one of the variants that I created for this material. So it is using exactly the same image, right? But you see, I have changed the intensity. I've added a little bit of cavity detection and also played with the colors A and B. I'm going to cover that in just a second. Just want to show you what this is. So this is another one that gives it more like a brownish tone, like a reddish tone, and another one that is more like a kind of like a golden iridescent material, which is pretty cool. So I think this one is kind of like my favorite out of all of them. And you see, I just added a bit more colors here to generate some variation. So let's go back to the first one. This is the one that I just created with the base image. And let's tweak this one a little bit. So before I actually start moving sliders randomly, I just want to show you that there's actually a reasoning behind which ones you might want to choose, or which ones you want to change or adjust. So as you can see, in most of these sliders, you have A and B. So those are colors, or like these slots right here. So for example, this intensity A, this depth A, the hue A, you know, all of that has an A in there, that refers to this color swatch in here. And the same thing goes for B. So anything with intensity B, you know, depth B, all of that refers to this B, right? Or this B swatch. There are a couple of other things that you might want to take into account that have to do with the other two, with these other two swatches, which, for example, this color or colorize is refers to this one right here. But we're going to concentrate on the A and B, or the yellow and blue swatches here, or the, sorry, sliders in, so that we can tweak what this matcap does. So if I go ahead and click on intensity one and push it, you see what I'm doing is brightening things up. So this is pretty intense, right? It's, you know, it's overexposed and doesn't look as good. But again, I'm just doing this to show you what this effect does. And I'm going to select the A color and set it to a green. And there we go. So we have like most of the iridescent material or that effect is gone because we have an intensity of the A color, which is green, set to 5. If I go ahead and set the intensity of B to 5 and set this to red, you won't see any changes because basically when you have A and B, you need to have some cavity detection. So it's these two colors are basically to play around with the cavity detection. So I'm going to push this all the way to 1. And now you start to see more of that B color in there. And in the cavity transition, you can start playing around with that and basically changing how the A and B is mixed. So again, this is very, very, a very, very strong effect, but those are the things that I look for or that I tweak to generate the other materials like this one, for example, right? So now that you understand some of the basics, so intensity A refers to this color and intensity B refers to this B color, but in order to see them, you have to have cavity detection. So with that out of the way, let's go ahead and dial this back to something not as intense, reduce cavity detection, and I'm going to change the A color to be just slightly yellow and the red one to be slightly green, or yeah, maybe almost blue, right? Very desaturated, very, very light, okay? So it's almost like those pale colors that we use when we recreated the material in Blender. So this one right here, if you remember. So these very pale colors, that's kind of like what I'm trying to do here. Even though the effect is given by the matcap, I'm just kind of like reinforcing those two colors in there. And once I have those, I can just go ahead and push the intensity of one over the other just to see what works. At this point, it's just playing around with these sliders. The only thing that is important is to know what the sliders are for, but you know, once you understand that, it's just a matter of like playing around with the values and see what visually works and what doesn't. So I'm going to reduce the cavity transition and knock this one down a bit. So I think that's looking pretty good. Another thing that you can do is to actually pinch or inflate the image itself. So let me just show you what I mean. So look at the image. This is what we have as our base. But if I click on this depth A slider or B, what I'm going to do is take this image and I'm going to kind of like inflate it or pinch it. So you see, if you pay attention here to the thumbnail, right? What I'm doing is just kind of like pinching or inflating that image. So this is pretty cool because I can sort of push it forward a bit. And all I'm doing is kind of like bringing those colors that were reserved to the edges or to the glazing angles of this material. Let's actually get closer here to the eye. That's probably easier to see. And I'm just like pushing them closer to the center, right? I'm going to do the same thing with B, right? So this is a very cool way of adjusting your material even after you have created the image. So you can have a single image in here and then just in ZBrush, play around with these sliders to adjust your iridescent material and create your a very unique looking metal material. All right, and to wrap it up, you can also use the saturation A and B to increase the saturation if you want to make things kind of like fully metallic. And this is making reference to the strength slider within the Newtonian ring that I talked about in the Marmoset video. So if you're interested in knowing about that or what I'm talking about, you can just go ahead and watch the same effect or creating the same iridescent effect, but in Marmoset Toolbag 4. So that's kind of like what I'm talking about here. If you set this saturation all the way to 1 for both, it's kind of like taking the strength in Marmoset to 1 as well. So I don't want to do that because that's way too much. But another thing you can do to alter this is to play around with the hue of A and B. So that ultimately changes the colors. So it's going to move the hue. So this is another way that you can use to adjust your materials. So I can go for like, you know, something more desaturated in A, more saturated in B, and play with the colors. Now I'm just like moving away from that sort of iridescent material, which is actually the intention of this tutorial, but I just want to show you that you can have within the same material, within the same image, the ability to change and create a bunch of different versions and a bunch of different, you know, metal materials and so on and so forth. So I'm going to select mine here. This is kind of like the one that worked for me, just so that you can screenshot this if you're interested on, you know, on recreating exactly the same values. So that I don't, you know, spend time showing you exactly what numbers are. You can screenshot that. And again, I'm using the same image in here. And these are the colors. Let me just hover over. As I hover over, you see that a little thing appears around here. Let me just do it. So just pay attention around this area. if I hover over this area, you see it appears there. So these are like the exact numbers that I use for these colors. Again, if you want to recreate that. So yeah, the red, green, and blue for the green color, the yellow for A, the blue for B, and the saturated yellow for the colorized. But anyway, all this information and the links to download the resources for this tutorial would be in the link below this video. All right, so I'm going to leave it here, guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers.